Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars with Earl and Nancy Stewart. Reach them with your questions at 877-960-9960.
The mystery shop is of Alan Turner Hyundai in Pensacola. Now, that's a long distance record. We've never gone that far, almost 700 miles away from the Earl Stewart on Cars studio. Agent X had identified his target, a 2008 Chrysler 300 with 90,000 miles offered for sale by Alan Turner Hyundai. 2008, that's a 10-year-old car. And you know about the Takata. The older, the more dangerous they are. That's about as old as they get. The online price was $9,065. He confirmed that it was under safety recall for a defective passenger side Takata airbag inflator by checking NHTSA, Carfax, AutoCheck, and Chrysler's own Mopar website. Agent X planned the mission for Thursday evening. As a standard practice, I called ahead. I'm speaking in the first person now as the shopper, Agent X. I called ahead to confirm availability. I spoke with a woman named Kelly, who told me she would have to check but promised to call me back. She kept her word and called me back within 10 minutes to say the Chrysler 300 was available. Kelly said she would have it out front for me when I got there. Kelly told me to ask for Michael when I arrived at our just scheduled appointment time of 7:25. I asked her if she was a salesperson, and she said that she was a BDC clerk, Business Development Center. New thing. Car dealers all have what they call BDCs. It's a phone bank, you know, boiler room, bunch of people in a room calling, answering phone calls all the time. That's all she does, sets up appointments. And she sets up for salespeople, and that's what she said she did. I pulled into the lot, found a parking spot next to what looked like the Chrysler 300 I'd seen online. I got out of the car, walked around the Chrysler. I caught the eye of a young man who appeared to be a salesperson. He approached, introduced himself as Craig. He asked if I was interested in the car I was checking out. I said I was and explained that I'd seen it on their website. Sounded reasonable? Okay, I said. Got the keys. Craig started the car, began to open the doors. I asked him if the car had been checked and found out to be mechanically sound. I was surprised by his answer. Craig said that this old 10-year-old car and almost 100,000 miles usually doesn't go through the shop for inspection. Kind of a strange comment.
Yeah.
This doesn't sound right. And I asked him if he was sure about that. Craig said he would double check for me, but then I noticed a large sticker on the windshield that read, Turner checked. Craig looked surprised and said they must have decided to inspect this one because it was so nice. He said the sticker meant it went through Turner's 27-point inspection. And, you know, most cars in South Florida have a 100-point inspection.
48, yeah.
48 in Northern Florida, Panhandle, 27 points. 27 points is probably plenty.
Yeah.
Yeah, but 48 points sounds better.
Well, when they get down to the point of where they're saying checking the tread on each individual tire is four separate points.
That should be one point.
And checking the pressure is four more points. Some of them get a little carried away on their listings is all.
Yeah.
So I asked, does this mean the car is mechanically sound and no issues? And he said, that's what it means. He suggested we take it for a drive as I helped him close the doors. On the test drive, I asked Craig if the car had ever been in an accident. Craig said, guess what? He would check the auto check history report and let me know. So when you're checking for a car, be sure you get an auto check or a Carfax report. Craig talked about the Turner philosophy and that they had no haggle sales process. Back on the lot, Craig asked me if I was ready to drive it home and how I planned to pay for it. I said I'd be using cash from a recent inheritance. He accepted my answer and made no attempt to get me to finance there or pressure me to fill out a credit application. Interesting difference in culture between the Panhandle car dealers in Florida and the South Florida. South Florida is truly the Sodom and Gomorrah of car dealerships. North Florida, more countrified, laid back, relaxed, and they're nicer in the Panhandle. I was left at the desk for a few minutes while I waited for Craig to talk with Michael and get some paperwork. He returned with a printed copy of the auto check report, like the Carfax, and what appeared to be a worksheet or buyer's order. The worksheet or buyer's order is always the first paper, typically a worksheet, and you don't see the real legal papers until you get into the box or the business office where they got the F&I manager, the business manager. He sat down and immediately disclosed that the car had been in an accident. He quickly pointed out that the report indicated the damage was only minor. He then showed me that there was an open recall for a passenger airbag inflator. He said he thought it had probably been completed and should be fine for delivery. So it's amazing that the fact that a car has a dangerous recall is never discussed at the beginning of the conversation with the salesperson and the shopper. And the only time it's ever discussed is when we ask about it, meaning the mystery shopper.
Yeah.
Or if you're the real shopper. If you don't ask, they're not going to tell. Don't ask, don't tell. If you don't ask about a recall, if you don't ask about accidents, if you don't ask about Carfax auto check reports, you're not going to hear anything. They don't want to do anything to mess the sale up.
Mm-hmm.
So the burden is on you. Caveat emptor, buyer beware. Know ahead of time if there is a car in the dealer's inventory that has a recall, and you can get it on safercar.gov. He sat down immediately, disclosed the car had been an accident, and he told me about the recall, said it probably had been completed, and it should be fine for delivery. You don't want to hear probably when an exploding grenade is the consequence.
Am I going to live?
Yeah.
Probably.
Is this a live grenade?
Maybe.
is this a live grenade? Probably not. Craig paused, picked up the desk phone to call Michael. He nodded his head and said, a few times as he listened to his sales manager. He hung up and said that Michael doesn't think the repairs were made. He said he was calling the Chrysler store down the street to see if they could do it tomorrow. He suggested we review my deal while we waited. Now, the obvious question is, why didn't you call the Chrysler dealer yesterday or the day before? Why didn't you call the Chrysler dealer when you traded the car in or bought it and get it fixed? It's free. Mm-hmm. The Chrysler dealer fixes it free. He showed me the worksheet and pointed his pen at the top figure labeled market value of $10,252. He said I was getting a discount off market value of $1,377. My sale price was $8,875, $190 less than the posted internet price. They added a $499 dock fee. Now that's a panhandle dock fee there. That's the dealer fee I charged when I was evil.
No, a little bit higher.
Yeah,
you were $495.
Yeah.
They beat you.
15 years. How long ago?
We dropped the dealer fee in 2003.
15 years ago.
Exactly. You remember the coup d'etat.
So Panhandle is charging a 15-year-old dealer fee. And then there was $439 for fees, which were not differentiated. And he said that was for license, titling, and sales tax. Out the door was $10,427.78. I asked him if he had any wiggle room and told him the out-the-door price at $10,000 even sounded nice to me as opposed to $10,427. He said they were a no-haggle dealership, but when I was ready to write the check, maybe they could wiggle a little. So if you're one price, no haggle, you can't wiggle.
Just
Michael,
a little bit.
Michael called back and said the Chrysler dealer had the part and would set up an appointment with me to get the airbag fixed. That's good. I asked Craig if he could hold the car for me until the morning so I could discuss the deal with my wife. He said he could hold it for 24 hours. We shook hands and I left. There you go. Here's the epilogue. Agent X never asked the third of the three questions because they disclosed the airbag recall and immediately took steps to get it remedied. Alan Turner was quite high in their opinion of the 2008's 300's market value. When I saw market value, that made me wince. Kelley Blue Book considers $7,200 to be the average listing for this car with similar miles and the fair purchase price to be $6,999. So, this begs the question, can you fault a car dealer for trying to charge you too much for the car?
No.
No. That's the system. And anytime you get a price from a car dealer, and there are a lot of them like this particular Turner Hyundai, they claim to be no haggle, one price. They love the word. It's a catchphrase, one price, no haggle, no hassle. They love that. Bottom line pricing is another phrase. That's to get you in the door. Don't believe it. because 999 times out of 1,000, you will find out you can negotiate a better price. It's very scary to put your bottom line best price on the car because they know you can take that price to another competitor, car dealer, and they'll probably beat it, or at least they'll try. So always negotiate. Don't believe no haggle, no hassle, and don't believe one price. I say that painfully because I have to, full transparency, I am a car dealer, and we do have one price. So don't believe me either. Don't believe anybody. I mean, I inherited the reputation. I used to be a car dealer. I know what I used to do. So be careful. Don't believe one price. I'm going to say C minus. I was going to give him a higher grade. I think we gave him triple opportunity to confess. Yes. We're putting Turner Hyundai in Pensacola on the recommended list. Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen.